Welcome to Marvel TLDR, presented by Noah Sterling. This is the series where we break down Marvel's greatest stories so you can jump right in and read the original adventures. Today's story is She-Hulk, Law and Disorder. Jennifer Walters is the cousin of Bruce Banner. After receiving a blood transfusion from her cousin, Jennifer turned into a super strong and super smart Green Giant. With super strength, a winning personality, and a law degree, she's pretty much better than you in every way. Currently, Jen is dealing with a civil case, and the defendant is none other than...
Steve Rogers! It's so good to see you! You're my new client?
Yep.
And you're old now.
Yep. Comics are weird.
Steve is being sued by the grandchildren of Harold Fogler, a man who had quite the story to tell on his deathbed.
It's 1940, and I just moved from Brooklyn to L.A., fell in with a bad crowd. And all of a sudden, my kid brother Sam shows up to bring me home, and he's got little Stevie Rogers with him. My boss is pointing a gun at my bro, and I'm trying to talk him down, and then this little runt, who ain't even Captain Frickin' America yet, starts blabbing all, "Look at me! I'm gonna talk all high and mighty to ya!" And that's how Captain America got my brother killed.
Wow, that's some story. Still, it shouldn't be a problem for us. I mean, you're Captain America. What lawyer could possibly discredit you in a court of law?
Hey, so, this is awkward.
Matt Murdock? Steve is your friend! Why are you the prosecuting attorney?
I asked him to do it. Wanted the trial to be fair and square.
Come on, Steve! This is a legal practice! It is not the place for morality!
The day in court finally arrives.
Harold Fogler's story was true, but incomplete. That rough crowd he fell in with? Hydra. And they were threatening to kill all three of us. Since we were all gonna die anyway, I told them how America rules and Hydra drools. And that's when they shot Sam.
See, folks? Captain America going against Hydra. Now, if that's not just how the world works, I don't know what is. Just one tiny thing, Cap. The police report from 1940 doesn't mention a secret Hydra factory. Care to tell us why that is?
I'd love to, but I can't. It's classified.
She-Hulk's investigator Hellcat gives her a file with the full details. Turns out the FBI was staking out the Hydra factory, and Steve's speech gave them the distraction they needed to swoop in and arrest all the bad guys. The head FBI agent was so impressed by Steve's courage that he recommended Steve for the Super Soldier Project, which led to Steve becoming Captain America and saving the world countless times.
This is perfect. With this file, we can...
Patsy stole that file from the FBI. It's not admissible evidence.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, he's Captain America, okay? Do you really think Captain America is lying about having stood up to Hydra?
We the jury agree with the scary green lady. We find Captain America innocent.
I really didn't want to be the guy who ruined Captain America's legacy in a court of law.
I'm sorry for putting you kids through this, but the truth just mattered.
That may be, but honestly, after all this, I kinda wish there was a supervillain to punch.
Funny you should mention that. Look at this letter I got.
Dear Captain Geriatric, I've used my awesome mind manipulation technology to get a dying man to accuse you of getting an innocent boy killed. Hugs and kisses, Dr. Faustus.
Oh, ouch! Oh, stop! I'm sorry, okay? Ouch!
TLDR, She-Hulk can tear apart tanks, but we thought it would be more fun to show you a superhero courtroom drama. You're welcome. Thanks for watching this video. Read the original She-Hulk Law and Disorder storyline on Marvel Unlimited, on the Marvel Comics app, or in graphic novel edition wherever comics are sold.